Down. Bad.
What's up, everyone? It's Rusa. I hope everyone is doing well. So instead of playing around and getting the perfect amount of footage for these vlogs, I'm going to just bang out as many as I can and keep the content rolling. I want to get back up to at least making 2 to 3 videos per week. I'm going to set my standards realistically. And then as I get back into the swing of things, I'm going to try and pump out content every other day like I used to. But let's jump into the back workout. So I just have some random B footage of the back workout I did, as well as a trap superset I do for my massively overdeveloped traps. Go check out some pictures of how ridiculous my traps are when I flex them on my Instagram at RussoLifts, and you can also direct message me there if you have any particular questions. Please do not comment anything to get this channel removed in the comment section. Shoot over into the Instagram DMs and we can chat. But I've been scheming, I've been thinking, how can I do this YouTube thing in 2018? And I want to hear your guys' feedback. Obviously, I'm gonna go through the comments after I'm done talking about this, but I'm thinking about basically redoing all my old video logs documentary style. So basically rehashing them, essentially. So I want to hear your guys' thoughts. Be sure to comment them down below. So what do I mean by that? Basically, I'm going to kind of re-edit them. Basically chop them up and talk over them. So, you know, my first SARM cycle, I could, you know, kind of documentary style, me looking into the past and really talk about the implications of what I did, what I thought at the time at my maturity level of what I was doing, you know, the side effects I experienced, and kind of just like overlay and talk with the knowledge I have now about, you know, my SARM log then, how I actually look from an unbiased standpoint, what my thoughts were at the time. And I think it would be a really cool way to not only try and, you know, fit these videos into the guidelines, because basically I'm going to be talking about the implications of what I did, and basically a very documentary style, like looking back on it, you know, type thing. It has nothing to do with promotion or anything like that, just purely informational and educational. And you could also learn a lot from it, as well as get to watch my insane transformation over these past 2 years. I don't think a lot of people have been following me since the very beginning, so I think that would probably be the easiest way for me to, number one, get back on my feet with content, as well as, you know, keep everyone happy with, you know, a new form of content, but at the same time really getting the value out of all those videos I made. So I have about probably over 200 videos that I could do that with. Yeah, around, so each, no, probably about 150, I'd say, that I could, you know, rehash, essentially. So let me know your thoughts on that. Again, the whole goal would be to fit it into the guidelines, as well as kind of just like sit back and like dialogue what my actual thoughts were at the time and what my thoughts are now with the experience I have, and, you know, what mistakes I made and how I could have corrected them, or I should have did this and that, and, you know, really go back and watch the progress. And for you guys, it'd be really cool because, again, it would be a really sped up version of my log. So, you know, I could do one each day, you know, comment over it, edit it up, and you could see basically 2 years of gains in like a couple, probably like 2 month period, and it would all be rehashed, and hopefully it would slot into the guidelines and be okay. So that is my thoughts. Let me know what you guys think, if you guys want me to throw up those videos again, because I know a lot of you guys are sick of seeing all that old footage, but at the same time a lot of people haven't seen like my first SARM cycle, my second SARM experiment, my third SARM experiment, which were only SARMs only, and then my transition to, you know, other things, and then test bases, and then trying out gear, comparing it, and then talking about that, and actually learning, you know, how strong are SARMs compared to gear, in my opinion, and like stacking and stuff like that. I think it could actually go well if that could actually stay on YouTube, if I put it in a documentary educational style. I mean, I see a bunch of documentaries on steroids that almost promote it, essentially, and they have been untouched. So I know they're like a film company, but if I take that exact stylistic approach to my videos, I don't see what the issue was. But again, it's YouTube. So I wanted to update everyone as well on what I'm doing as far as, you know, my current bicycle. So I've been cruising for a while, and it wasn't really my plan to do that. I actually wanted to take a break 2-3 months ago, I'd say, but you know, with, you know, all the bad luck I've suffered, I decided to continue it just in case, you know, I could get back on my feet with current content and current progression. But now I definitely want to take a break, and it's almost to a point where I'm below TRT right now and have just been cruising like the smallest dose possible, to a point where my balls actually started gaining size back and are pretty much back to normal. My loads are like back to normal because that's how low it's been. But I was also substituting 20 to 30 meg S23, so I've actually let the TRT ester completely run out. So my lab rat is utilizing SARMs only right now, which is S23. And yeah, so that back footage is technically SARMs only, and I'm going to do a PCT and get everything checked out, see where I'm sitting at, and take a break. And yeah, I wanted to do that a couple months ago, but you know, I thought that if I could recover the second channel, I would continue it until about this point, and hopefully I'd be back at around, you know, 8,000 subscribers, but you know, YouTube had other plans. But that's what's new with that. And my acne so far has kind of been stagnant, and I'm probably going to have my lab rat do low dose Accutane at this point. Again, the whole goal was to see how far I could recover my skin, you know, without it, because, you know, Accutane does have a lot of side effects, which I'm aware of, but from this point, I don't know how much it's able to recover, and Accutane obviously is a lot more effective than what I'm doing. But to be honest, I recovered my skin amazing, like, or not amazing, that's not the right word, drastically compared to how bad it was. It has come back a ridiculous amount. So that's an update. Be sure to leave comments on what you think. Again, I don't know if that whole thing of rehashing my old videos is going to work. I think, you know, putting face cam and everything and just showing how much progress and strength gains I've made in such a short period of time would not only be entertaining to look back on it, but also to learn from all the implications of what I did. And that's an educational documentary styled, you know, video series. So I don't know what the fuck qualifies it if that's not, you know, able to be put up on YouTube. I guess I'm just not allowed to talk about it in general. I've been really following the activist on YouTube, you know, Psych Substance being the biggest one, on what he's doing to get around the guidelines and slot into the guidelines. And he basically did a DMT video, which in my opinion, DMT is a lot crazier than, you know, PEDs legally too. And you know, he actually got the video fully monetized, and I watched his entire video, exactly how he shot it, all the disclaimers, and I'm going to try and implement that into my old videos. So that's what's new. I wanted to update everyone on that, and I also wanted to, read the comments. Thank you to everyone who commented and participated in the comment section. You guys honestly cheered me up. I thought I wouldn't get anyone in the comment section because I just took so long of a break. But I don't know how to like say how much I appreciate you guys checking out this video and giving me a third shot, but I seriously do appreciate it. You guys are awesome. So, Traplets. Resub, bro. Took 2 seconds to sub to your new channel. Let's see who's rocking with you, bro, with 9 uplinks. You know, I really appreciate the comment. Muscle Players. Be sure to check him out. He was affected by the whole YouTube bullshit. So be sure to check out Muscle Players. Wow, watching you talk about your channel was like me talking to myself into a mirror because I feel the same way. Yeah, I mean, it's not just with the whole SARMS thing. This is YouTube in general is just going downhill so fast. I mean, not even just like this little gray area stuff. I'm talking about big mainstream channels are being drastically affected. Like, this is across the board an issue. And, you know, I'm waiting for a platform to step up and challenge. And I'm waiting for, you know, creators with a bigger following to really take that initiative to boom that new platform. And, you know, I'm sure it'll be a lot more uncensored. And that's where I'm going to sit my ass where that happens. But until then, I got to make do with what I got. So Justin Roth, the moment a viable alternative to YouTube is available, I'm done with them. YouTube has become a disaster. So many of the channels I've subscribed to have been affected. Hang in there, man. YouTube's days are numbered. I couldn't agree more. YouTube has changed so much in these past couple of months. Again, I've been making YouTube videos over 2 years. You know, the channels you guys have normally seen me, I've been working on those for 2 years, but I actually had an older gaming channel that I worked on years before that, which I did completely for fun. And the things you could get away with back then compared to now is insane. The things you could make money off of. I mean, I don't even want to bring up what, you know, used to be on YouTube. And now they're taking it to such an extreme so fast. It's kind of pathetic. So Skinny Lou, thank you for not being a Fortnite drama PG-13 porn channel. I look forward to the 3.0 channel videos. You know, I appreciate you checking out 3.0. And yeah, I'm always going to make videos that I would personally sit down and watch. This is a video I'd probably watch while I'm doing something else, just listening in. But I'm not about, you know, going too mainstream. I think, you know, the reason people watch me was for my niche. And I 100% get that. That's why I personally watch myself. But it's all battling, you know, this bullshit to actually still be able to make my content. Alright, this is a good question. How come you get a bad skin reaction on cycle and many people only have small breakouts? Is it just genetics? So yeah, I never had any real skin issues. I'd say minor acne before test. And I had bad skin before in puberty. And I don't have the greatest skin. I have overactive sweat glands. But, you know, with all my experiments with SARMs, I never really suffered extreme acne, probably slight acne. You know, the second the test came in, that's where it all went downhill. And I never even, like, took my cycle for my lab rat with test to an extreme level. Again, 500 to me is a lot, but in the grand scheme of things is nothing to what, you know, some people's test subjects end up using. And, you know, my goal wasn't really to blast it, was just to try, you know, a higher dose. And yeah, it eradicated my skin to a point where, you know, I don't think I'll ever really mess with quote unquote high test again. I never really had an issue with MPP. My skin actually started regressing when I made the switch. And yeah, that's all genetic. Again, some people are very DHT sensitive, so their hair is heavily affected. Mine is obviously skin. Alright, those were some of the questions. I appreciate everyone who commented, as well as everyone who discussed and participated in the comment section. So, basically, I wanted to make this quick little vlog, if you want to call it more like an update video, on you know, my thoughts after really thinking about how to continue. And, you know, that's what I came up with. So let me know what you guys think. I really want to try and do some collaborations. I don't know how many people are going to want to collaborate with my little subscriber number, but maybe I could say I had older channels and, you know, they wanted to discuss things on Skype and maybe get Tony on a Skype call and do some topic stuff with that. So that's also in the plans. Again, currently going to be trying to bring it back, and you know, I've been really trying to get more motivated to pump out content. But I do have some good topic ideas that I'm going to do, as well as, like I said, really my big project would be to rehash, you know, redo the old Swarm log videos and do a documentary style where I narrate over my old videos. So let me know what you think of that, and let me know if you even want to see that, because a lot of you have probably already seen the newer vlogs. And I'm sure a lot of my OG subscribers, because you guys would probably follow me forever if you're following my third channel, have probably seen the original Swarm logs. But I think I could provide more information with the thoughts and knowledge I have now on what I was doing at the time. And I think it would be really cool to kind of like sit back and react to my old videos and talk about the implications of what I did. So let me know if you guys think that's a good idea, and be sure to check me out on Instagram. That's where I've been staying the most active and trying to interact with everyone on there. And yeah, I should have more update videos next week on stuff revolving around, you know, the future of EA and stuff. All right guys, I'll see you in my next video.